Hello everybody, welcome back to the workshop. So today I'm going to talk a little bit about how sometimes trading work for work or your work for an item is sometimes a good thing. So thank you all for watching this video and I hope you enjoy. So let's get right into it. So here recently I had a very kind gentleman, he goes to my blacksmithing club, Southern Ohio Forge and Anvil, and he traded me some tongs that I was making for a mechanical iron worker. And this is a huge blessing in my business to be able to trade something like that. But he valued my time so much that he was willing to trade something that he had for my time making him a tool. So tools for tool kind of thing, type trade. So that works out. Sometimes that doesn't work out, or it doesn't work out for both parties. Sometimes it's not a fair trade, if you will. So you might be thinking, well, man, trading tongs for a mechanical iron worker, that's one heck of a deal. I've also made some things for him for free in the past. I've also generally have listened to him, heard him out, just been there, provided value. I provide value up front, and out of that value that I was providing up front with teaching and knowledge and things of that nature and other stuff and making tools just out of the blue for him and stuff in the past, out of that, he returned that value in kind, with this very generous trade, and I really thank him for that. I'm not sure if he watches the channel too much. He's an older gentleman, so he probably doesn't. But again, I got to be able to trade him something that I've made for something that he had in tooling that could help out my business. So this is just a little encouragement video that if you are finding it hard to find the tooling that you need, stop going to people and expecting them, and I see this a lot, expecting them to give up what they have for next to nothing or free, because you're not presenting a good trade of value. You're not offering them anything in exchange. If you have a product that you can give them, or say, hey, I'll trade you 2 forging hammers, any type, or 3 forging hammers that I make off of that anvil, if you would just trade it to me, because I'm working on this Harbor Freight anvil and it doesn't work out, or I need a better anvil, you've got a spare, would you be willing to trade if I forged you some hammers or if I forged you some tongs? Of course you got to make sure that they're worth that trade. They can't be sloppily done or something like that. You want to add value. So think about how much value you can add to somebody else before you ask them of a favor or to just do something for dirt cheap. Because ultimately, the tools of this trade cost a lot of money. They just do. And I don't see them going down anytime soon. They will eventually. Things go in a loop in blacksmithing. It's popular now. It'll eventually die out, again, as far as popularity is concerned or mainstream, and then it will pick back up again. And it just does that in a loop. You be around it long enough, you'll see this happen. Stay in it long enough, you'll end up seeing this happen. So again, the tools, the costs, the griping about power hammers and forges and drill presses and equipment and tongs and hammers and things like that, it doesn't really get anything done for you, except it doesn't build any bridges. It doesn't make any friends. In fact, it just makes a bunch of enemies. Because you can say, oh, here comes that guy again. He always tries to haggle me on my prices, and I really can't afford to give him anything for that price, right? So if you are in that position where you're needing tooling, think of the amount of value you can provide to somebody if you don't have the money, but you have the time. Provide your time, provide your skills, provide your services for in-kind type of work. This could also be applied, let's say you want to learn blacksmithing really, really bad, right? And say you've got a guy that you want to take and have a mentor as, or you want mentorship from this person, okay, of some sort, or to be taught by them or a class. Offer to be a teaching assistant. So you will help him carry his tool bag in and whatever, and you don't expect any payment whatsoever out of this other than just to follow him around and learn what he knows, and his knowledge alone is enough for you. Chances are, that guy's not going to take advantage of you on that. Chances are, what he's going to do is he's actually going to probably help you out and help you along your journey, because you took out of your good nature, hopefully you have a good nature, and you had your heart and mindset in the right place, and you were trying to provide value, not extract it from someone. So you're trying to provide them with extra value in their life, and they say, hey, you know what? That's nice of you. Let me do something in kind. And the whole blacksmithing community could work like this. Again, you're not entitled to anything. You're not entitled to a good shop, a big shop. You're not entitled to all the tools and equipment out there. You're not entitled to the knowledge. The entitlement thing's out the window. You have to work hard for everything you get in here, and every inch of ground, in reputation, in business, and in family, and in life, and in friendships. You have to work hard at it if you expect to take and have anything in return. That means you have to work hard at providing value to those around you. So that's it for this video. I hope that encouraged you. If it did, make sure you leave that like button. This is one of my first videos that you've ever seen. Consider subscribing. Check out the rest of the videos on the channel. There's getting close to over 700 of them now, just as the recording of this video. So make sure to check out the other videos on the channel. I might have something that interests you. Good chances I do. And like always, and like I say at the end of every one of my videos, God bless you, and we will catch you on the next one. Thanks for watching.